See, not this. This is a time machine.
Sometimes there are episodes that you just know that, like, we have to do this. It's just, like, too perfect. Like, it's got a genre, it's got, like, fun, but then it also has to, like, refract on one of our characters. Otherwise, it's just fluff and fun.
I love you.
In 40s Hollywood, like, that was the one I was like, we have to do that, because it was like, it was Coen Brothers, kind of that world of, like, wacky golden age of Hollywood that I'm also passionate about.
You really think they'll fall for this stunt?
Have men gotten smarter in the past few thousand years?
Nope. But then it also had, like, a really strong sort of, like, message about what women were able to do, during the Trojan War, what they're allowed to do in the 40s, and what they're allowed to do now, and what they're allowed to do on Legends. And it became this perfect story for Zari, and for Sarah, and for Amaya.
What's wrong? Are you all right?
Can we please go back in time and murder whoever invented stockings?
The ones that you know are gonna be winners also speaks to a particular character, and you're like, oh, this is gonna be that character's episode.
Guys, here I come. I mean, little me is coming at you. Catch up with me on Main Street?
And, keep me alive.
The morning I came in and I could see, like, people were excited about something, and that was actually our writer's assistant, Ty. Somebody was like, pitch it, you gotta pitch it. And he was the one who was just like, okay, what if it's all about young Rey? And it's not just a gag, and it's not just a plot. It becomes about one of our characters, and it all of a sudden had the emotional resonance of telling a story about who Rey Palmer was. I think there's something very humanizing about, like, the way that 80s portrayed families, because they're all, like, a little effed up, but, like, full of love. I feel like what we're living through now is just kind of like the 80s, but, like, on steroids. So, like, it's nice to go back and sort of, do it on a sort of simpler scale.
God, I hope this works.
One of the parts that you can't live without is, like, the music. And our composer, Blake Neely, was like, look, if I do, like, E.T., I'm gonna need, like, a John Williams orchestra. And so, you know, for the score, we had the full live recording studio with strings. Actually seeing our young Rey going across the moon with them playing live, you're like, oh man, I think this actually delivers. I'm getting goosebumps, like, watching my own show.